basically said to the girls, I know they were.
Too far on this end. A little bit more. Right there. Okay, now you're center.
Are you going to get, not get an exit sign? Wait a minute, Daryl. Are you going to miss the exit sign over there?
Pardon?
There's an exit sign over there.
It's in the picture, yeah.
You've been trying to.
Cherish and adore. privilege and an honor for me to work with you, but you inspired me to do some things since I left McClure that I think have helped other young people along the way, and so I thank you, and here's the class of 1969.
Wayne Cooley, who wrote in, he was our president, he became a geologist for Gulf Chevron. Today, he is a hydrologist for the state of Arizona. He's married and has two young boys.
Melanie
Fisher, who is here tonight, is a lawyer for Southwestern Bell. She's the mother of two and avid baseball fan and family person.
Carol Wald, local. Worked as a training consultant for the graphic design equipment. Until recently, she is now a new mother. She and her husband adopted a beautiful Korean baby.
Girl. Pro golfer, Steve Cox, a golf pro. Steve Brooks played pro basketball in Italy and the Philippines. And Al Rubin, our state wrestler, I'm happy to say, did not go on to become Randy Macho Man Savage. Elementary principal. Yeah, I'm so proud of Jackie. I think that's really great. And I'm sure she's wonderful with children.
You people that know this story. Don is now dissecting plants. He used to dissect human anatomy. And for those that do remember, he did have part of the X phase at Logan Chiropractic. Dave Olson, Denny Woods, Bev Connolly, Sally Nussbaum, Rita Petrus.
A lot that have been married for the first time. I think that's a good story, Cal.
We do have a very fine committee, and by putting everything together this evening, we think that everybody should be recognized. Everybody in Rossville would like to introduce, and just please stand and we'll hold the applause until later. Jan Schubert.
Good
This will be brief because I want to get into those crushing dances or whatever it is we're going to do. Incident, and I remember how well behaved our students were that particular day. Everybody left class. Ludwig Park, and I don't think you still have figured out how we figured out it was smoking in the trees, do you? Well, we had a very clever business education teacher, and M1 with binoculars. Oh, and I remember the water fountain in M3, and did I hear it's out in Missouri somewhere? On the farm! Well, that's a story in itself. I remember the bus caravan to Jefferson City. Fantastic musicals that you were in, and I remember how many kids were involved in those musicals. It was absolutely a phenomenon to see McClure High School involve so many kids in activities, and that's why McClure was so great. To beat Oak Park and win the state championship game, we were driving home, and one car went by with a piece of the goalpost sticking out of the back window. Another car went back with the mooner sticking out of the window. I got home, and I'm not sure who got called, Charlie Winscott or Roger or myself, but someone called and said, I want so-and-so in your office on Monday morning. So he called the student in, and of course the father had his family in the car and the children, and he didn't appreciate the mooner. And so he gave me the name of the student. I called him in, and the father pointed out to the young McClure student that he didn't appreciate that kind of behavior, mooning his family on the interstate. Of course, I was having a difficult time controlling my emotions. But I never will forget, as you probably know, the parent called the license bureau and got the car license, got the name of the kid, and of course he didn't say that. And we dressed the student, I suspended the student, he walked to the door, and he turned back and said, Mister, how did you recognize me? games in 1 year, winning 3 titles, and that was probably unheard of in most high schools, to win 3 championships within a year. Smoking in the Johns, yes, I remember that, and the punishment that you get now for cheating on us and having signals is you have to change your kids around now. It's a lot like us, chasing you around. Two other little tricks we learned, and that was all the parking problems. All we had to do was get on the intercom and say, there will be a wrecker here in 5 minutes. The class is empty and the kids are running for their cars to move those cars out of the no parking zones. Yes, and I remember the Washington, D.C., New York trip when I became an administrator, and they sent me off on this trip with these wonderful McClure students. We got to Washington, and we sponsored Regina Jerswick, some of you remember her, and we thought all the students were in their rooms because it was curfew. So we went downtown to look around, we looked through the tavern window, and there they were.
Sitting with Dr. Ludwig is Coach Johnson. Stand up. Mr. Brandenkamp. Mr. McClcuer. Mrs. Kester.
Maybe I guess bad, just throw stuff in us and won't hurt for 30 seconds, please.
People have been employed for 20 years with the same company already.
You mean they've been employed 20 years out of high school or what?
20 years out of high school.
That's a long time.
Here we go. Rick Uhlemeyer. Was Rick here?
Was he at? Rick, come on up.
Come on up. He's been with Hertz Company.
Who's been with McDonnell Douglas? Likewise, we've had some people who have been employed for 20 years in their job. We've had some people that have actually been married for 20 years. Can you realize that?
I can't realize years. That.
I can't either. Anyway, the next award is the Endurance Award for graduates who have endured marital bliss for the last 20 years. First person we'd like to bring up here is Tony O'Hare. Is Tony here? Come on up, Tony, if you're here.
Married to Larry Bernstein, a graduate of 1965 McClure.
We've had some people here that are actually celebrating wedding anniversaries. Can you believe that? This is the Cheap Date Award. See, I can just see this, you know. Hey, honey, how about going out someplace for dinner? Sure, let's go to my reunion, huh? Okay, well. Anyway, we have some Alan Montrey celebrating his 17th wedding anniversary. Where you at, Al?
Entertain us at Halloween every year. Randy Russell married to Sandy for 17 years.
And I get her anniversary night for 16 years, Candy.
I hope you enjoy your evening. This is the Danny DeVito Arnold Schwarzenegger Award. Joe, do you understand what this is?
Yeah, this is an award for twins, isn't it?
We want to recognize those graduates who have had twins. And the first recipient is Nancy King Brown.
Next of all is our own Mike Conant. Go ahead, Mike.
Congratulations. All right, this next award is for, what is this award for, Mike?
Well, this is the award for, you missed your what?
This is the Late Night with David Letterman Award.
Right. These are the people that have had the most children in our class from what we can figure out. Again, this is unscientific.
The first recipient is Jerry Hill.
Four children.
Awesome.
Four children. Come on, okay. Okay, we're moving right along here. This is a good deal.
We told you this wasn't scientific.
I tell you what, if you paid for this, I'm sorry. Where's Kathy Schrick at? Kathy has four children.
The next is John Britton. John also has four children.
What do you get for having four kids? Linda Lufkert just had four children. Linda? I don't think she's here.
Carolyn Lowes? Kelly here? Also four, is that right?
Okay, how we doing? Oh, God. Not a good one.
Standing now. Everybody stay standing. Stay standing now. Stay standing.
Okay.
We need to figure something out here.
This is,
if you have children that are 18 years or older, keep standing.
Healthcare as their career path. And we'd like to recognize the following people.
Lynn Beeman.
Come on up, Lynn. As your name is being called, come on up.
Pat Beckman. Ron Oldie. Norma Smith. Tom Benson. Judy Cooksey. Christy Farr. John Macon. And Barbara Jo Whitsey.
Gary Kaler. Linda Hogan. Candy Andrew, come on up. Bill Clark, that's right. Health foods are good.
Surgeon.
And Bill Wright is in veterinary medicine. Come on up. There's a doggy bag for being in veterinary medicine. We have another announcement to make here, just been brought to our attention. Any DWIs, illegal wiretaps, DUIs, street walking, or counterfeiting. We're going to be giving the following person the Night Court Award.
And that goes to Jeannie Fisher.
I love
it. Virginia, Texas, and Maryland.
Oklahoma, Connecticut, Minnesota.
Arkansas, Colorado, and Ohio.
North Carolina, Washington State. The Bristows came from Washington State. And we're our runners-up for the coming the furthest.
Georgia, New Jersey, and Kansas.
And Indiana. And by the way, you can all pick up your luggage in the lower lobby.
Is this a drama? And we have a variety of different things that we're willing to bring home to Japan, including some TWA wings, some coloring books,
and a barf bag.
And a barf bag.
Either as a hobby or as a profession.
Diane Porter has been on ESPN with her pom-pom squad at Pattonville High School. Come on up, Diane.
Carol Rhodes spends time singing and acting. Carol?
Of course, Sue Scantlin, who had a beautiful song here at the beginning of the evening. Sue, come on up and receive your award. Don't you agree, it's a beautiful, beautiful rendition of Amazing Grace, everybody?
Thank you, Sue. Sue also sang in many weddings for a lot of us.
Mary Ann McQuinton, is that right? McQuiston, okay. She's on Oprah Winfrey. Come on up, Mary Ann.
But we don't know why. We want her to tell us why.
We want her to tell us why.
And Shirley Harlan, we talked about earlier, she was an actress for the Kansas City Police Academy, and we don't know why yet. We'd like her to explain that to us.
Cinema. $12.
The next award goes to Casey Van Allen, the voice of KMOX Radio, Clue Radio, CBS Network, and was the master behind the music we enjoyed earlier in the evening. Case, Kenny Clausen. Also the voice of...
Okay.
Good to see you, Steve, on the body.
It's going to be a body slammer, I know. Preston Harrison made a mountain out of a molehill. He climbed Mount Fuji. I don't know. There's been many nominees for this next award. And this was an unscientific way of doing things. We had the girls in the committee vote for the gentlemen, and the men of the committee vote for the ladies. At this time, we'd like to award the Grecian Formula Award, which everybody has been waiting for, I'm sure.
And the award goes to Mike Williams.
Okay, Mike. And Sharon Brazo, where you at, Sharon?
Again, the men of the committee voted for the girls, and vice versa. And the Ben and White Award goes to Nancy Lane.
Thank you. Rich, handle this, will you?
Make it work, Rich.
And Mitch. His wife's not applauding anybody. Also, in the last 20 years, we've had a lot of people who have really changed. Either for the best or the worst, I guess, right?
Yeah, most of them for the best. You take the other part.
Okay. We have an award here for the graduate who has changed the most.
And that is Jerry Amaro.
Jerry's gotten better here.
I can tell you, he changed the most. He showed up to play golf this morning. I didn't know who he was.
And no robbers. Where you at now?
They wore earlier. And the guy that best fits this description, we thought, was Charlie Costello.
And the lady, Lynn Ostercon. In closing. At any rate.
They took my beer away when I tried to stop the tape earlier.
We had fun anyway. Anybody else who wants to come up here? Come on up.